simple random walk model, probably the simplest random walk model, and I derive various subdiffusion direction equations from this simple model. The equations appears to be not too simple, very interesting, and has a very complex structure. I consider two examples of equation, parabolic subdiffusion reaction equation for both reactions and hyperbolic subdiffusion reaction equation. This is quite new equation. Sorry. Let us consider the simplest random walk model. We assume that the particle takes its steps in the system with discrete time and space variable, and the particle can't jump with probability 1 over 2 to the right or to the left. This process is described by this difference equation. P denotes, of course, the probability, n the number of jumps, m discrete final sites, and m0 is the initial position of the particle. And we are interested in finding probability for continuous variables. And after solving this equation, we have to pass from discrete to continuous variable. This passing will be performed in two steps. The first, in the first step, we pass from discrete to continuous time. Using the generating function, which is defined to be as follows, and in the subdiffusion or normal diffusion model, to find the probability for continuous time, we use the following formula. This function phi m n is the probability that the particle takes exactly n steps in this time interval and continues to exist in the system. What means? In this model, the first model, we involve the chemical reactions into the functions phi. The difference equation is standard for the normal random walk, but the reactions will be involved in this function. in terms of Laplace transform, I omit here the details of calculations, but in terms of Laplace transform, the Laplace transform of this function is following. Omega is the probability, it's a probability density of the time which is needed for a particle to take its next step, and the particle continues to exist in this time. Um is the probability that the particle does not perform any steps after when goes to the final position. Combining these equations, we get the fundamental equation of this model. This equation shows that if we know the generating function for the process under considerations, and if we assume the functions omega and um, then we have the Laplace transform of probability. This is important equation. The example, the example of the generating function for the system without reactions is the following. After simple calculations, we get the following equation, for the homogeneous system without the membranes, etc. And the following differential equation for continuous time and discrete position. So pass from discrete position to continuous spatial variable, use the standard formulas where epsilon denotes the distance between discrete sites. And finally, we take the limit when epsilon goes to zero. So after simple calculations, we get the Laplace transform, general Laplace transform of the equation. In the continuous time random walk approach, the omega for the system without reactions are usually assumed to be as follows. This is the limit of Laplace transform of omega for small s, which corresponds to the to long time. The parameter alpha for subdiffusion is assumed to be smaller than 1. Epsilon equals to 1 corresponds to normal diffusion case. And the function u is this probability, that's Laplace transform of these probabilities given by standard functions, very easy to calculate. The subdiffusion coefficient, d alpha, is defined as follows. Tau alpha is this parameter. And after simple calculations, we get the following Laplace transform of equations, of subdiffusion equations. Due to this Laplace transform, you get the very simple subdiffusion equation with fractional Riemann real time derivative. But I do not confine this term. This is a solution of the equation in terms of Laplace transform, solution of normal diffusion equation without reactions. And due to following formula, using the function which is denoted by f, this is the special form of H-Fox function. The solution of normal diffusion equation is subdiffusion equation without reaction is the following. This is an example of plots of these functions. You can see that subdiffusion is different from normal diffusion. For normal diffusion, we have Gaussian functions. Subdiffusion appears in a system in which mobility of particles is strongly hindered due to a complex internal structure of medium, as for example in gels or in porous media. How to include chemical reactions into this model? If a reaction can occur, the particle A and B must firstly meet. And after this meeting, we assume that the probability density of particles vanishing due to reaction is following, is the exponential function distribution. Gamma is the reaction rate. Of course, the probability that the reaction does not occur in this time interval equals to this function. And we introduce a parameter P. This is a probability that the particle NAB can meet with this probability. We assume the following reactions, and for simplicity, let us assume that P is static and the particles B are homogeneously distributed in the system. This function omega equals to this quantity. This omega is the probability for the system without reactions, and is multiplied by appropriate probabilities. So omega m is the probability that the particles takes the next step in time t and continues to exist in this time. The Laplace transform is following of this quantity, of course, and after calculations we get rather complex Laplace transform of probability density and rather complex form of differential equations. Calculating the inverse Laplace transform and using the following transform of Caputo fractional derivative, we get this equation, which is not appropriate to practical use. It's too complicated. Let us note that presence of the fractional derivative is due to special form of Laplace transform of these equations in the previous, in the previous equation when we see the, this quantity as alpha multiplied by p, then the inverse Laplace transform, the inverse Laplace transform provides the fractional derivative. Let us consider two cases of the previous equations. The first one corresponds to this reaction. For this reaction, p equals to 1, and the probability distribution is following, and equation is this. This probability and equation was previously formed by Igor Sokolov and et al. There was used another method. This is important factor, damping factor, which is exponential function of time. In this reaction, we must assume that p. We should assume that p is less than one. And in the long time limit, which corresponds to small s, we end after introducing a new parameters, m square is the new reaction rate coefficient. We get the standard subdiffusion reaction equation, and the solution of this equation is following. This is similar to the previous, but the damping, this factor, exponential factor, is controlled by, is a function of x, x minus x0, distance between initial and final position. So, it is interesting that both of the reactions can occur with the same probability, with the same subdiffusion constants. But character of these reactions provides quite different solutions, different functions. There are plots of both solutions. Solid lines represent the function for the first reaction, dashed lines for the second reaction. And we can easily we are able to generalize the previous equation to the non-linear case, assuming that this is natural, that the reaction rate is proportional to the concentration of beam particles, and the assumption, standard assumption, is that this relation is valid also for the case where, in which the concentration is a function of x and t. Then we have obtained the following equation for and for this reaction, more general reaction, this equation. And now let us consider the persistent random walk. And we consider the case in which the particle B is located in one position M R and B is static. And this reaction can occur in this point. The persistent random walk is assumed to be a random walk with, in which the successive steps are correlated. The parameter beta controls the correlation and can be interpreted as a probability that the particle, the sense of velocity vector of particle is the same in the next, is changed in the next step. This process is described by this for the, this, these equations. The upper index plus, minus and plus denotes the sense of velocity vector of particle. L beta is the reaction rate in this model. And the reaction rate for the non-persistent random walk, this is a probability that the reaction occurs when particles stay in stay in MR position. Can be calculated from this formula. And for persistent random walk, we assume that this reaction rate is a function of beta. The reason is that it's motivated by a simple reaction model. After rather long calculation, we get the equation for probability. This probability describes the motion of particle A, and this is a really long and rather complicated equation. The solution of this equation is following, and where we introduce new substitution parameters which depends on parameter beta, and the solution, so this plot shown that the solution strongly depends on parameter beta. For various beta parameters, there are values of beta parameters, and we can generalize this equation using the method as in previous case to the non-linear form. This form has a very interesting properties and in my opinion can be used successfully to describe various processes in biology, medicine, etc. My conclusion of my talk is that the random walk model provides is a very useful tool for modeling various diffusion processes in various systems. And the second conclusion is that the persistent random walk changes the dynamic of subdiffusion reaction processes. The details of calculations and the application of this model to describe subdiffusion in a system in membrane are presented in the following papers. Next papers are in preparation. Thank you very much.
antibody reactions, you neglect the correlation.